Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Caleb and Meg. The Church shares. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love, these your servants, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Now let us be seated for the reading of God's Word.
Read from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall now show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give everything I own, if I give everything the way I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered, it is not brutal over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Caleb and Matthew. Have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His Church? Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, turn and face each other, join your right hands, and declare your consent before God and His Church.
I vow to you, Meaghan, with my lawful wife, that I would hold and stand forward for better force, for richer form, and the sickness of life, the love of the cherished.
May the Lord in His kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the Church and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessing within you. May the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you have declared before the Church, so that what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Thanks be to God. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Stand. Dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Meaghan and our brother Caleb, let us commend them to the Lord in prayer. That these faithful Christians, newly joined in holy matrimony, may always enjoy health and well-being, that he will bless their covenant as he chose to sanctify marriage at Cana in Galilee, that they be granted perfect and fruitful love, peace and strength, and that they bear faithful witness to the name of Christian. That the Christian people may grow in virtue day by day, and that all who are burdened by any need may receive the help of grace from above. That the grace of the sacrament will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married persons here present. And that you, O Lord, may graciously pour out upon this husband and wife the spirit of your love, we pray, make them one in heart and soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love these your servants, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Now let us be seated for the reading of God's Word. Let us pray. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those who have already joined in this holy union and replenished with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May God, the Eternal Father, keep you of one heart and love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully in the eternal dwelling of God. And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Caleb Jones.